Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for your goodness and for your mercies that endureth forever. As I bring forth your word, use me as a vessel to bless your people, O Lord. And as you bless them, my Father, do not pass me by. In Jesus' name, amen. My name is Florence Minor, welcoming you to yet another time of Celebrate Your Moment. To enjoy this beautiful day, this historical day in America, Independence Day, 4th of July. It is good to walk according to the seasons of time when you know the truth about that season. Today is 4th of July, and I have some information which I got from the website, and I know you know it, but it's always good to remind one another. 241 years ago, that was July 4th, 1776, America gained its independence. And I have this information. The Declaration of Independence, drafted by a committee that included Thomas Jefferson, John Adams, and Benjamin Franklin, announced that decision to the world. In future generations, it would come to be a manifesto of American ideas. We hold these truths to be self-evident. It says that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain and unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Of course, it's important to remember that these rights have not been equally afforded to all of America's inhabitants, like black and brown people, women, and the minority. Thomas Jefferson wrote the Declaration of Independence as part of a committee of five other Continental Congress members that also included, as I said there above, John Adams and Benjamin Franklin. But the Congress made heavy edits to the document later, and Jefferson may have even borrowed some of the language in the Declaration of Independence from the British philosopher John. Those are facts, and you can get more detailed ones. I thank God for each and everything. History is good. It makes us know things even when you are not there. 241 years ago, nobody was here right now living, but we can get what was going on from the history. So I want to challenge you, be a person who want to read more about the history. That's how I know the history of the Independence Day that we celebrate today. But I want to tell you that you can live in the land of the brave. You can live in the land of the freedom, United States of America, yet be enslaved in your heart, be enslaved in your internal life. And so this time I want to introduce you to the Son of the Living God, Jesus Christ, who can give you freedom, and freedom indeed. The Bible says in John 8:36, therefore, if the Son of Man makes you free, you shall be free indeed. I don't know where you are at. Are you in this land of the brave, this land of freedom, and you are enslaved with bitterness, enslaved with competition, enslaved with prejudice, enslaved by sin? I want to tell you, you can be free of all those by recognizing or accepting the Lord to save you. And you can be able to sing confidently like the singer who sang, I know who I am. Wherever you could be, as young as you can be, as educated as you can be, as whatever color, whatever origin you can be from, you can be free wherever you are. Why? Because once the Son of Man sets you free, you are free inside out. And as you walk, despite the hindrances, despite the challenges, you can walk saying, I know who I am. I am a child of the living God. I want to introduce you to this freedom that we get in the Spirit, such that as we celebrate this Independence Day, you can be independent in your heart. May the Lord bless you. Let us pray. Father, in Jesus' name, help us to know the truth so that the truth can set us free. In as much as we know the history of this land, in as much as we know the history of wherever we have come from as a migrant, help us to remember there is one universal freedom we can get in Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. May the Lord bless you. can continue being blessed together with Celebrate Your Moment with Joy through GSM TV network. It's a free app. You can upload it from your Play Store. You can also join us for a full program on Wednesdays, and may the Lord bless you.